Doesn't that bring it back?
That really brings it back.
We should do banjo sometime.
It's a lot better than this game.
Like, decidedly. No, don't you dare. Don't hear us. Did you see the promotional thing that they did for Ukulele where they got the guy who did the DK rap back to do the Ukulele rap?
Grant Kirkhope?
Yeah, they got Grant Kirkhope to do a brand new rap for Ukulele. And it's just as bad.
I wonder how he feels still having his name on this.
I mean, it's still got good music.
Yeah. Hey, you take that back.
What, you don't think the music in this game is good?
Oh, still got good
it's
music.
Still got good.
I heard still not good music.
Oh, no. Grant Kirkhope makes amazing music.
Yes, he does.
Every time I hear one of those songs from Banjo-Kazooie, and I'm like, oh god, I know exactly where that's from. It's terrible. This is way longer than I remember.
Yeah, it is still going. Also, I like Lanky Kong's cop.
I like that he's confident showing off his belly.
Exactly.
Oh god.
Oh god. T minus what? 2 minutes and 38 seconds to part joke.
There might have been one before, I honestly wasn't looking.
Yeah.
Lanky and Chunky are the two Kongs who I used the least.
Oh, Chunky was the best. He had a lot of cross applicability.
So slow. I remember getting this game.
Uh-huh.
And at the time, I was young, and I was very into this collectathon style.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. This rare 3D style.
I might have 120% in, or whatever this game makes you go up to.
Yeah.
You did too.
Yeah, I did one time. And then we lost that cartridge in the flood.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's awful. I can't believe I would have done that now.
It was antediluvian.
How did I find that kind of time?
Yeah. We have different priorities.
That's fair.
But going back to the Grant Kirkhope question, how do you think Grant Kirkhope feels about the fact that the only reason this game needed an expander for the memory size and the RAM on the N64 was for this animated intro? That was the only thing. The entire reason you needed that red cart was because they front-loaded this.
That can't be true.
100%. This is like the largest piece of data on the Nintendo 64 cartridge.
Wow.
Yeah. It's insanity. Alright, we're playing Donkey Kong 64, and it's your usual crowd plus one.
You guys were actually playing this?
Yes.
Oh yeah.
We're doing this.
Alright. I thought this was maybe like an elaborate prank on me. No, what? Okay, yes. So, hi, everybody.
This is my friend Neil from Part-Time Gamers.
Yeah, you can go to Part-Time, or actually, God, I can't even show my own stuff anymore.
Oh, man.
You can find me and my buddy Matt. We do podcasting and some other stuff on ptgamers.org, and you can find me on Twitter at ThatNeilJ, where I also do, like, Twitch streaming and a bunch of other... I'm out there. You can find me.
I'll put the links in the video.
Yeah. I'm not too worried about it. I'm just here to have some fun.
We picked a very bad game to have fun with. When I downloaded this initially on the Wii U, this is the Wii U ported game, it didn't dawn on me until getting hands back on it with this piece of hardware that was at least marginally more current than Nintendo 64, that the cameras are bad.
The cameras are not good.
It really shines in this version of game, too.
Does it?
I mean, coming off of the success of Banjo-Kazooie, it can be really easy to think, gee, we can take this formula and apply it to any IP.
We can do no wrong.
And then this happened. And then Star Fox Adventures happened.
Look at that, like, bad sprite of a seal.
The pirate seal.
I think I played through Star Fox Adventures.
Oh, I definitely beat that.
Yeah.
That's one where you, like, fight dinosaurs.
With a staff.
Bow staff, right?
Bow staff, yeah.
And you have, you have a... Triceratops sidekick.
Sidekick would imply that he helped at all. Basically, you just had to feed him mushrooms to keep him from dying.
Or, actually no, because he could breathe fire. And sometimes, if you didn't want to waste a mushroom on getting him to breathe fire, you could just hit him.
How do you remember this much about that game?
Tony played the game a lot.
I played the game a lot.
Yeah.
Jesus
Christ, this game is 95% intros.
Yeah. See, you 100%ed this, I 100%ed that.
Wow.
and I did Banjo-Kazooie like a civilized child.
I mean, I also...
I'm pretty sure I did it to Banjo-Kazooie also.
Exactly.
And Mario 64.
Mm. We also did, like, Dark Souls all the way through, so, like, that's us.
Yeah.
So, weirdly enough, the first Dark Souls is the only one I haven't done all the bosses in.
Oh, which one did you not do?
I did not do, oh god, why can't I remember the name now?
Because you didn't do it.
When you go to Anor Londo, there's an optional boss after
Gwendolyn.
You... Yes, so I never did Gwendolyn, and when I did the Painted World, I got to Priscilla, and she was like, we don't have to fight, and I was like, okay, cool, and I just bounced.
Priscilla is a dragon lady with a soft tail and a scythe. And Gwendolyn is the second son of Gwyn, who was raised as a girl and has snakes for legs.
Yes. Relatable content.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So I didn't do either of them. Is there another one in the first game I would have skipped? I don't think so.
There aren't that many optional bosses in the first game.
No.
For Mario 64, I 100%ed all four files on my copy of the game right now because I was doing training for the charity stream I do every year.
For which game?
Mario 64.
Oh, are we like speedrunning it?
Did you like that plug, folks?
Yeah. Well, I didn't plug it yet. I didn't say the name of the charity. No, I just... I tried to speedrun it because I'm the one who plays Mario 64. It's like a four-day straight marathon.
Okay, cool.
And we raise money for Child's Play, which is awesome. And me and this other guy named Jeff are what they refer to as the ringers. Because we're the ones that actually are good at video games. So... I'm pretty much solely responsible for Mario 64, so I had to, like, figure out where I can cut corners and stuff like that.
Nice.
Scott's really good at platforming games. Mm-hmm. Like, really good.
Alright, so...
Let's see if that happens.
So the plan is, you never die, so I don't have to touch the controller, right?
That's the plan, yeah. God, do you remember those guys with the spiky hair, and each one is the color of a Turkey Kong?
Yes, I can't remember their names.
Like Wesley Crusher or something like that. And
no, they're Crushers.
Yeah. And then
they do the there
you get the blueprint. That you, Jesus, this fucking
you guys. How are we not playing the game yet? It's been like 12 minutes or something, right?
It's been literally 9 minutes.
Oh,
okay, so hang on. They all get captured. Whatever.
Sure.
How?
Doesn't matter.
Well, like they were already in the cells before the gates closed.
Yeah.
So how did you trick them? But like these scenes always have like his visualizer of what's going on. It always shows sort of a version of what actually happened during the game.
But it doesn't.
So I think that these are more dream sequences for King K. Rool.
Wait a minute. Are you actually no?
We're almost,
not yet.
We're almost
there.
There.
Almost there.
All right, your edging is paying off, Neil.
Squawk,
don't
squawk.
Call it that.
Right, there we go.
Please don't call it that.
Oh, beans. I like the fact that he's got just a poster of his girlfriend, like a full-size poster print on the wall of his house of candy over there. Oh, that's bad.
I've watched a speedrun for this game before.
I like that his claw attack is slaps.
Because people are crazy. But I'm sitting here thinking, there's a way to, like, skip into the ice world, like, right off the bat.
Wait, there's an ice world?
Yeah.
What?
What? I don't remember that.
There's a.
You like go up the hill and there's an ice place, right?
There's a desert.
Is there an ice one too?
I guess we'll find out!
I don't know that we're gonna get that far.
Maybe if we could. Maybe we'll stumble into that trick and get into the ice world.
Accidentally.
I remember the Egypt world.
Oh, boy. Oh. Don't look at the man behind the curtain.
Well, they had seen us with our pants down.
That's what this channel does specially.
It's okay, it's not the first time.
When I was recording a game with Matt not too long ago, there were three different circumstances where other games that we were going to be playing finished downloading and popped up on screen. Damn it!
That's awesome.
We tagged it as spoilers and left it in.
Sneak preview for next time.
Exactly. Alright.
What? So you finally...
Oh, this is the training.
Test barrel.
Okay. I was going to say, you're finally playing the game, and it doesn't look like you've done anything.
I blocked this whole bit out.
There we go. Alright, so... I'm so used to doing, like, C-stick control with the camera, but if you use the joystick, it goes into, like, first person. It's this bumper up here that you use to reposition the camera.
That's bad.
It's very bad. I mean, what? We're having a great time.
This is great.
It's Tactica.
What's the L button do then?
I don't actually know yet.
Okay. You should press it and find out.
Because this one, you're behind the curtain, this one right here. So.
I like that sticker.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that.
Are you trying to tell me something?
For the people listening who can't see, they're on the lower side of Scott's gamepad for the Wii U is a sticker that says, eat a bag of dicks.
Yep, they just kind of showed that straight to my face.
Yeah, that was my... There's hearts on it, though.
A bag of dicks.
Once upon a time, I worked at a coffee shop that had a label maker, and one of my coworkers made a bunch of these and stuck them in my coat pocket at the end of my shift. And so I got home, and there was one that said, hello, please stop, and one that said, no, thank you, with a skull and crossbones, and then one that said, eat a bag of dicks. And when I was moving, I was like, I don't really have a reason to hold on to this, but I don't want to get rid of it.
I should probably be paying attention to what you're doing so that I know what to do when you hand me that controller.
It's just
A and B. It's like, don't worry, we're all going to be part of the voice.
Oh, yeah, I guess this was an N64 game, so the C buttons would have just been camera movement.
Well, the C buttons were camera movement, but then they also had inputs like for drawing your gun and throwing grenades.
Oh, I thought that was because you have to crouch for that, don't you?
Yeah, so you hold crouch, and then I think it's X and Y on the gamepad are... here we go. We'll see. Pick up the oranges and hold... I don't have that button or that button.
Oh, boy.
All right.
So what's crouch?
Oh, there I go. It's left.
Okay.
Let's see.
Try...
Oh, that's pretty bad, too. Here we go. Okay, so it's, this is the C-pad, this other joystick.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come on. There you go. It's a good job, buddy.
You gotta flick it?
Kinda. It's responsive technology, what can I say?
Could just put the buttons on the touchscreen for us. That would have made it way easier, right?
I mean, that's how they did Ocarina of Time 3D, and that worked fine.
But that's only for, like, menus and stuff, right?
Yes, but you have to change items on the fly in that game.
Well, also in Ocarina of Time, get down there!
There
we go. In the Ocarina of Time port to the 3DS, they, also had the gyroscope for aiming, which was, like, if you were not trying to do gyroscoping, was really annoying, because you'd be, like, holding the thing in your hand, and, like, you move your hand a little bit, and all of a sudden you miss your shots.
I turned that feature off.
I just got used to it, because you can pinpoint your aiming a lot better if you just embrace it.
Which, this is the argument about the Star Fox game developed by Platinum.
Oh, yeah, the, Star Fox Zero?
Star Fox Zero, yeah. Because you use the gamepad for that.
And, like, the screen shows the usual view of the thing, and the gamepad screen shows
the
your thing. Yeah. Which is
basically, what I've heard is that once you learn to do that, it's really cool, but the learning curve is like a wall.
Steep, yeah.
That's kind of what I've heard about Splatoon also. Like, the way you can go up and down with move controls is better, but, like,
getting used to it isn't super intuitive.
It's an innovative, air quotes, way of getting around the fact that controllers are not as good for aiming as mouse and keyboard.
I mean, in this and that, there are circumstances where I would definitely prefer to have a controller.
I like it for third-person shooters a lot better than a mouse and keyboard, but...
Like, it's no problem for, like, Mass Effect. Oh, you have to do a Sidian Slam on that thing.
No, that's the... I can't interact with the dirt piles until I get my musical instrument.
Right.
Use the musical instrument.
You have to play the bongos on the dirt and it gives you something.
Gives you the super coin that gives all of the Kongs 5 coins or something like that.
Hold on.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound right.
Doesn't it though?
No, don't the music things have like...
Right, there it is.
An entire switch? Don't you just get like a ground slap for the dirt?
No, there is a special move. It's something like the musical instruments, but it's like a twister.
You know, just get through this damn door.
We're finally in the game! Look, it's me, Donkey Kong.
Maybe if Donkey Kong let his friends into his, like, gated palace, they wouldn't have been captured.
It's really about classism.
You know what? There's actually a solid argument for the first Donkey Kong game being about classism.
Let's not go there. Oh my god, I don't need you.
Banana board.
This is seriously killing me.
And you're not even playing yet.
I know. I just like, I need us to get into a level.
I think I have to talk to... What's his name again?
There's a fairy.
Plumpy or Chumpy or something like that. No, it's the big croc that's in the gate.
Oh, right!
And he, every time you get him a key, he does a dance that breaks something that opens up the way
you're
in the
level.
What?
Yeah, no. Because...
Yeah.
I remember none of this.
K-Lumsy. That was super close. Yeah, that was almost Clumpy.
Did that alligator? Crocodiles?
What are they called? Kremlins. They're called Kremlins.
Excuse me, yes. There's classism. Come on.
Shh, it's fine.
Do the Kremlins have bigger on the inside technology? Because this dome...
Makes absolutely no sense.
No.
Yeah.
Also, those locks don't make any sense. That's not keeping him in there.
It's more of a...
What if...
An emotional...
What if we were playing Donkey Kong Country?
We'd be playing a good game then.
Yeah. We'd also be on like the 7th level by now.
Probably.
Decidedly.
Probably what? Done with the first world even.
What was the... Because there was the peripheral for the GameCube that was the bongos, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And it was used for
Jungle Beat,
and it was used for Donkey Konga, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Jungle Beat was the one where it was a platformer game.
Yeah, that game was actually kind of cool.
It was awesome.
I would have loved to play it if it didn't have that control gimmick.
No, it was super good with the control gimmick, because you hit two at the same time to jump, and then you clap to do an attack. It's awesome.
You see, you know how Dark Souls as a rhythm game had like a learning curve for you?
Mm-hmm.
That had a learning curve for me.
Oh,
that
God damn it, Tom.
I didn't bother getting.
Lucas had those bongos.
Lucas was really good at that game.
Yeah, he and I 100% did Donkey Kong Jungle Beat or whatever. Donkey Kong, one of the two.
For those of you watching / listening, the trend for the day is we make poor decisions with our time.
Mm-hmm. And we're in.
Also, what the fuck is this thing?
I think it's the prototype for Planker, which is an actual NPC character in Yooka-Laylee.
It looks like...
1700 years later.
It looks like the cousin of the mask from Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, Aku Aku's alcoholic uncle.
There you go.
Yeah.
You got there.
What? Who?
Aku Aku is the floating mask that helps out Crash and Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, okay.
And then the bad one is called Uka Uka, which is the same thing but backwards. Stupid.
I gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
But like, you know,
I was thinking of Mumbo Jumbo. Like, he's got that same kind of mask from Banjo.
Yeah.
But that's his face.
Yeah.
He kind of just, at times, looks like a bird.
Oh my god, are you in an actual level?
It's level time! But they spawn me 4 feet in front of
the
top.
Oh my god, you still can't move.
Mega Man!
There's your boss gate.
Yep.
Alright, hold on. I need to see something.
We're at 20 minutes to first level.
Oh my god. Oh boy.
Oh no.
Neil was so excited when I invited him to play games with us.
We won't play this the entire time.
No, look. I brought this on myself. I said I'd opt for anything.
You know what? If you had vetoed this, we could be playing Kirby right now.
Or like one of the many PlayStation 2 games that we have on the backlog right now.
I could actually really go for Kirby.
Now we'll do that next. we'll stamp this with a date that this one was filmed. Oh, god damn it!
It's okay.
Why are your health watermelons? What does that have to do with
I was wondering about that earlier, because monkeys don't...
Tropical fruit?
But like, okay, the whole thing's got bananas, right?
Yep. Bananas,
and so collecting bananas, that makes sense.
Sure.
As far as I know...
Oh yeah, you gotta go rescue.
Watermelons aren't like a thing in the jungle like that.
Mm,
where are watermelons made?
Monkey? Well, I mean...
Other than like...
Oh my god, shut up.
Generally in fields with poop.
Mm.
Which is why where the monkeys come in, because monkeys throw their poop.
Ah, that was a horrible thing that you've just done. Eat it.
Go rescue Diddy.
Yeah,
he plays an actual good character.
I'm gonna say, are you actually like... it's been a while, but it seems like all you're really doing is getting these teleport pads.
Yes.
I'm just going out of my way to activate them right now so that I have access to them.
Oh yeah, and then go get your gun.
Oh my god.
Don't you have to collect something for that?
I like that I think you have to buy it with the coins.
Probably.
I like that they turned Funky Kong
Wait,
into
what,
like...
Wait, what, teleporting already? Yeah. Yes. What just happened?
Peter Brawl. That sounds like something different.
Yeah, good job, Rare. I mean, this is the company that made Conker's Bad Fur Day.
They are British.
We could be playing Conker's Bad Fur Day.
We literally could, I have that game.
That seems like a way better... Like, it's still got problems, but...
You could be playing Star
I'm
Boss
pretty
Adventure.
Sure. Let's not get too...
Yeah, let's not get too big for our britches on this one, Tony. I think I won.
How many were you supposed to kill?
I was just supposed to survive.
That was it.
Honestly, I'm pretty sure...
Gameplay!
They all die in one hit. I wonder, would they have kept spawning in if you weren't killing them?
Oh, god damn it! No, they wouldn't have.
So you could have just kept running around with three beavers chasing you.
They do pick up in speed, though. Eventually, like, if they run for long enough, they become faster than you, so...
Do you have to hit them, or can you just jump on them?
You can't jump on them, actually. This is straying from that tradition.
Okay.
What I was going to say about Funky, though, I like that they turned him into, like, the Jews run the government, I shit in the woods, sort of like conspiracy theorists, like red.
I can see him taking over a government office and holding it up with fully automatic weapons.
Oh, yeah. That's absolutely... Like, he's got satellites, he's got militant attire. Like, he's just terrifying.
Which is, like, the furthest... possible thing from the cool hippie dude.
Funky Kong, exactly. I think I need my gun to save Diddy.
Yeah, you need to shoot the thing.
God, shit. You might need to talk to Funky, he says. Maybe you shouldn't have gotten trapped in this goddamn cage.
Welcome to
Fetch
Quest, the game.
Alright, you got... Yes, Donkey Kong coconut guns.
Mm-hmm.
We watched the rap, I remember.
It fires in spurts.
If he shoots you, it's gonna hurt.
He's bigger. Faster.
No, we're not doing this again, goddammit.
First member of the DK.
Fine.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you very much for this.
I was wondering the context under which we would end up playing this game, because I knew it was going to happen at some point. This is, as good as it gets with this one, really.
Pretty much.
See Funky's store. He's got chain guns. He's got a missile that's got his name spray painted on it.
He's got blueprints for IEDs in that back room.
Yep.
I mean, he used to just control the airport, right?
No, IEDs. Improvised explosive devices.
Yeah, no, but didn't
in Donkey Kong Country, wasn't he like the airport dude?
He was the guy who got you from area to area, right?
Yeah, he was the hippie guy who had the biplane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, we're gonna have to cut in on the Donkey Kong Country theme song like 9 times during this video.
Hey, yo.
Donkey Kong, let's go. Let's go.
Is this a TV show?
Yeah, there was a badly 3D cartoon in the 90s.
Not great.
Oh, boy.
It's very floaty.
What?
The animation.
No, but what?
They had no weight to them.
No, but what? Oh, wait, I think I have to hit the other switches. That's what I'm doing wrong. Oh, god damn it!
One of these days.
There we
go. Okay, so one of them is at the bottom.
One of them is down here.
You might have fallen a little too far.
That's fine. He'll walk it off. He's a cool guy. My god.
I mean, he's got a tie. I guess that's pretty cool.
It's trendy, at least. Oh, jeez. Bees.
You can't kill those.
Just shoot the button, please.
Yeah, I think I have to get up here to get a good line of sight on it and not get attacked by a bee. Okay. There we go.
Oh, what's that?
That's the,
it's a bonus world, right?
No, that's the boss gate.
You gotta go in there to feed. There's a hippo and a tapir?
No, a hippo and a pig.
Okay, it's a pig.
There we go.
And you have to... Yeah, there it is.
How do you guys remember this much about this game?
You underestimate how much Scott played it.
Also, just the sheer encyclopedic nature of the way that I remember things that are absolutely useless.
Is there really...
I mean, that part's there.
Yeah.
they have scales, and you have to feed one of them bananas so that he can become as heavy as his friend.
I think the rhino is the one that you feed, because and the pig's always the heavy one.
Yeah.
So you feed the rhino so that they can become the same weight?
So that he can turn a key to open the boss door.
Yeah.
And only one of the Kongs can fight the boss. There's a specific Kong.
Not always. Sometimes it's your dealer's choice.
Sometimes you have to do the boss more than once with different Kongs.
Oh yeah, there's a dragon thing.
Yeah.
You have to fight it with Diddy Kong the first time, and that's not so bad. Mm-hmm. And you have to fight it with Chunky Kong the second time, and that's garbage.
Yep. And you have to, like, throw rocks at it or something.
Yeah. No, exploding barrels.
You only hit two buttons.
It's always exploding barrels.
Yeah, that's right. The other one's down here, though, isn't it?
Yeah, probably.
I have no idea.
Nailed it.
Hey!
Here he goes, Banana Slam.
Is it like there it is.
So, oh no, I know what I have to do. I have to, because it despawns. The draw distance is too bad on this game.
Hold on. You literally can't shoot it from here?
Try. Oh, you can see it. Yeah. You can see it.
Let's see if this. Oh my god.
What if you shoot it and then, like, jump into the water really fast and chase your bullet?
Oh, that's not a bad call. Oh my god. Come on! Come on, donkey! Jesus frickin' crap. Stop this at once!
Can you climb up and try to shoot
it? Yeah, you gotta get it from the angle, yeah. Because then the button doesn't despawn.
This seems very bad.
What?
That childhood memories.
Man, I got childhood memories that are telling me that I played a lot of this game and had fun. But... like, I'm not even playing right now. Just watching this is making me question...
the whole time stand with it.
Yay!
Yippee, way to go, DK. Now that I'm free, I can help you. Why don't you grab that banana?
This is my favorite part.
Oh, fuck.
He teleported away. He didn't need you to open the gate.
He's like, now I can help you. And then he just leaves the only useless thing. Or the only useful thing, yeah.
Every DK or every Kong has their own color banana in this game.
The small ones that you collect are the individually colored ones. The golden ones are across the board. Anybody can pick up a golden one. And that's
But if you're 100% in the game, you have to get all of them every level.
Yeah.
Which means I am really not happy with myself and my life choices as a child.
Here he goes.
I mean, that's
just
that was really cute.
Oh god, get the. You goddamn...
damn dirty apes.
Yeah.
There, we made the joke.
It happened.
The joke everyone was expecting.
I don't know about that. I wasn't really expecting it personally. Come on, you...
Oh, it's such a good game.
What are you talking about?
Tony, you're... No. Just gotta...
There we go.
And Diddy has to beat him.
I know.
Does he?
I was just getting that coin. If I beat him, then he drops a blueprint that I can't pick up because it's for Diddy exclusively.
Oh, I think I remember, like, because I didn't think about this, but I remember why this collectathon is so much more arduous than other rare games.
Because you have to switch between the characters.
Yeah, it's the normal collectathon times 5.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Wow. Not first
bad.
Try.
Not bad. Thank you, and I will take whatever you want me to drink, Cranky. Turn me into a rhinoceros.
Oh yeah.
I don't know how.
I have perfected another of my potions, donkey. Mm. And it's yours for just 3 coins. You won't get much farther without it, so I suggest you pay up.
We always refer to Donkey Kong as Donkey Kong. Doesn't really sink in that his actual given, like, Christian first name is Donkey.
Well, you look at what this game is asking of you. And obviously, you're a workhorse, so...
My favorite thing about this is that... What? What? Hi?
He missed.
Anyway. Sorry, I was looking at this gummy. What happened?
Nothing good. Nothing you'll be happy about.
He tried to kill the beaver, and the beaver killed him.
No, the beaver phase stepped away from me as I was hitting it, and then ran towards me, because this game is very lonely.
It was a hyper-light beaver.
Exactly.
You could be playing Hyper Light Drifter. That's a great game.
Literally could be. I also had that game.
We tried to do a recording of it, but we lost the footage.
Yeah.
Aww.
That's one of 3 that we've lost now.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Which I'm really upset that we lost that one because of that, like, great revelation you had.
That amazing Yeah, Discovery. Which,
you know, I'm going to bring it up again now.
Yeah, it's good timing.
You know the game Runbo?
No?
Indie game from a Canadian studio. It's like a...
It's it was originally made for the Wii U, and basically the way that the game works is you can have up to 9 people playing, because you can have nunchuck and Wii controller and then gamepad, so it's 4 controllers split in half and then 1 extra controller, and it's up to 9 characters doing an obstacle course from point A to point B, but they're very quick. It's like a 30-second run, and you're just trying to maliciously attack your combatants while finishing the race.
And all the characters are like brightly colored, and they have like a standout silhouette. And
sure.
And all of the characters, it's like there's 2 main characters. One's
where
called like, there's a, I just got a banana. Yeah.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Over there.
There's a ton of indie game guest characters. Drifter is one of the characters in it. Shovel Knight's in it. What the fuck? the Tesla Mancer from Teslagrad is in it, and a bunch of other cool characters like that.
And when Scott first brought up this game to me, I was in the middle of the boss fight with the first boss, the bird thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, sure.
And
sure.
I like offhandedly mentioned to him, "Yeah, we know the guy. We know the game director. We went to high school with the game director for Runbo."
Turns out that a guy that I saw Kiss in concert with at one point in my childhood.
You saw Kiss in college?
Yeah. It's a weird time for us.
That's a different story. I was also there.
Are they still performing?
They were at that point. That
they,
was like,
they were like 6 years ago.
That was like 2011, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, they were doing this really... They were doing an obscure North American tour, and it was obscure because they were only going to cities that you wouldn't expect them to perform in. Like, where we're from.
Our hometown.
Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah.
They actually canceled tour dates at a couple of other larger cities so that they could make it to our shitty town.
I mean, that's cool.
Yeah.
It was
we had an
nuts.
Opportunity to see Kiss.
I got to see Gene Simmons spit blood on stage.
Classic. Thanks for the gun. I'm all a right. child, and now I have
yeah,
armament.
He literally just gave you Berettas.
Yeah. Arming children. Donkey Kong 64. 4 stars! 10 out of 10!
And to think, like, so much of what exists in this game, Diddy Kong with his, like, jetpack barrels and pistols,
is
now in Super Smash Bros.
Like, things that really canonized with the character. Yeah.
Yes. Like, so much of what is in this game is now canon with...
in Super Smash Bros.
Oh,
most
wow.
people's, like, preferred version of the character.
You know what?
Alright, I don't want this yet.
Like, Diddy Kong is also
isn't that a banana?
I don't know if this is
no,
true, but...
it opens up an area, but yeah. I want to get the guy with the blueprint first.
At least in Brawl, wasn't Diddy Kong, like, in the meta, one of the more OP characters?
Probably.
He was in... So in Smash 4?
Yeah.
The Evo Champion Grand Finals was a guy playing Diddy Kong versus a guy playing Bayonetta.
Ooh. Fame is hard to play.
And the guy playing Diddy Kong is the one who was favored to win because he's won, like, 70 tournaments in a row or something?
God damn.
Yeah.
Dako Umehara.
I can't remember the guy's name because I don't really follow that scene. Whoops.
My candy fell.
I only just started playing Bayonetta for the first time a couple days ago, like the actual game.
We could be playing Bayonetta.
We could literally be playing
that
Bayonetta.
That game is
right
great.
Now. It's a very good game. But I started playing it, and then I played Bayo in Smash last night when I was hanging out with a couple of people.
Mm.
And I only just now that I've actually played the real game understand how her character works in Smash Bros.
Nice.
Because she,
what?
Got aim up, but... Wait, no, you didn't even
have
to aim up! You just have to aim... What the hell?
Oh my god.
I am calling bullshit on that.
You can call whatever you want on that.
Oh my god, I hate this game.
What? Oh no, go to the... Get the bomb? Okay.
What?
Bombs all the time.
Grenades?
Yeah.
There's grenades in here too.
Okay.
I wonder if I'll need Cranky's help in here. Probably. Maybe not.
That's a weirdly specific thing for me to think, isn't it?
So it must be another new power you need?
Yeah. I think it's...
Oh, he gives you... Does he give you the jetpack?
Not here.
This early in the game, I don't think so.
No, he gives me something.
No, but like everybody has their own, like... Donkey Kong turns into the Rhino?
Yeah, I was gonna say, the fucked up thing about,
Tiny Kong shrinks.
Yeah. Funky grows, or Chunky grows, sorry.
Lanky becomes a balloon.
But also...
Plays himself just like a balloon.
Also, there's a, thing that happens in, I think, one level, maybe, where one of the characters gets transformed into a swordfish.
Oh, yeah, that is also...
Lanky,
yes. Yeah. They don't all have an animal, do they?
I don't think so. But anyways, the fucked up thing is that he gets transformed into that using what's his name's magic? The magical potion. And God, what's his name? The Cranky. Cranky's magical potion transforms Lanky into a swordfish.
Yeah.
Cranky's lab has a gigantic swordfish skeleton hanging on the wall. Where did he get that power? What sort of dark things did he have to do to that specimen?
So what you're telling me is Cranky Kong is a necromancer.
Absolutely, yes. That is what I'm
implying. Cranky Kong is the Earl of Kareem. 2017 confirmed.
What?
It's a Dark Souls
game. I know. Because every time you brought up the Earl of Kareem, I said Abdul Jabbar, and you got mad at me. I was there also.
Okay. Sorry, I'm like having a fever dream or something right now, and I...
What the fuck happened there?
It's like trying to describe the plot of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure to someone who's never seen it.
Mm. So it starts
that
off...
That seems a lot more comprehensible than this.
It Does starts it? Off and there's vampires, but you'll never guess what next.
Well, no. Starts off with a stone mass.
Mm-hmm.
The vampires come later.
Then vampires. Then mystical kung fu breathing.
Ah, yes. The Hamon.
Then revived 15th century knights of Mary Queen of Scots.
Yeah, that happened too.
Oh, we're going through all of it now? Okay.
No, this is all just part one.
No, I know.
What the frankenfuck?
You got hit by the grenade.
I know, I got hit by the grenade. I didn't think they were that good of shots is what I was questioning.
And then... Boy, yeah.
Get me out of here.
Then you get super vampires.
Mm-hmm.
And magic bubbles.
Oh,
and cyborg Nazis.
Yeah.
All this and more.
And then magical ghostly manifestations of your fighting spirit. That can literally do anything.
Is it just me or like... What came first? JoJo's stand stuff or Persona?
JoJo. It was Araki wrote it back in the 70s.
Okay. Part 4 preceded Persona significantly, and it's cool because Part 4 is basically Persona.
I was going to say, because like, I don't know a lot about Persona, but I definitely watched JoJo's and was like, what? Is it just Persona now? What's happening?
Yeah, it's like Persona 20 years earlier.
Okay.
Except you can ask someone what would your stand be, but you can't really ask someone what would your persona be because of the way the lore works.
I'm unfamiliar with Persona. I've got nothing to add to this.
I feel like asking what someone's stand would be wouldn't work either.
It kind of does.
But like...
You can put some thought into it. Think of a band you like.
Or like an oddly specific musical reference,
yeah.
And then a power that you think is cool.
Yeah, literally, that's it. CeeLo Green did it.
What?
Yeah, he kind of.
He became a golden stand man. At,
yeah,
an awards.
He became a golden stand man at the Grammys.
Yeah.
He was Gnarly Davidson.
That is accurate.
Okay.
I don't feel like we need to worry about being dated, because that happened a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what...
CeeLo kind of showed up to the Grammys looking like the final boss from Spelunky.
Yeah, he looked like,
his
C-3PO was also a pimp.
Yeah, that's pretty fair. Come on, Diddy.
Right, that,
That's what I need Cranky's help with.
Grenades!
Idiots.
Like, I enjoy a lot of CeeLo Green's music, but I definitely haven't been following the Grammys.
Okay, so, he released a music video and a brand new song after that, coming off of the hype of his new character, his new persona.
Sure.
His new stand, if you would. It is a cover of the song Jesse's Girl. Same tune, except it's called Jay-Z's Girl, and it's about his love for Beyonce.
Oh, no. Oh, what the fuck? And shit, goddamn.
You know, after all that talk about Scott being really good at platforming,
it's not shining.
I'm gonna blame the game for him here, but...
Oh, crappy.
You got better hurry.
Oh, no. Don't overshoot it. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Oh, right. Crying out loud.
Oh, I forgot.
Can you, like, go around it?
No, you can't. There's no way.
I clipped through. God damn it. Thank you for this.
I mean, would you like to take the controls for a spin, Neil?
I'm going to do the minecart, and then I'm going to call my time with this stuff.
I'm going to say no, but...
Why don't we just cut into a better game after we're done with this?
I'm good with that. How about we just...
Give me the controller for just long enough to feel how bad it feels.
And, like, maybe get a banana or something, you know?
Get a banana.
Because, like, it's been a long time, and you're not making this look like it's fun.
And that's not even a reflection of me. That's just what we're looking at. All right, how many coins? 50 coins. I can do that.
Left, right, and jump.
Yeah. Tilt, tilt, leap.
He's getting really obnoxious later on. Fungi Forest. That was, I remember that level.
Oh, yeah.
They had giant killer tomatoes. Whoa. Do you have to get all the coins?
No, you just 50. Have to get 50.
Oh, good. No big deal.
There's other ones, like, I think they get up to 175 on some of the later levels. Alright.
I really wish that this was a fun kind of level where you pay attention to what was going on.
Yeah.
As opposed to having to look out for these spinning coins.
God, shit!
God, no! Yeah.
I'm gonna have to run this one again.
It's fine. Everything's fine.
Come on, Diddy.
This is just like... You guys haven't been to Disneyland?
Once or twice.
This is just a, like, weird, bad-looking version of Indiana Jones.
Yeah. More or less, but mostly more.
I mean, it takes a lot to make the speeder bike sections of Star Fox Dinosaur Planet look fun. But this is doing it.
I'm sorry, speeder bike sections?
Yeah, there's speeder bike sections. There's two. They're both bad.
Quite.
What are all these, like, things in these games that I have played and don't remember that you guys know about?
There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, one of them is that you have to race two sharp claw soldiers to the bottom of the snowy hill.
To save rescue. Prince Tricky.
Yeah, you're Prince Tricky.
God, shit.
Your Triceratops sidekick. And then the other one, you have to race four Sharkclaw in a looped track.
Hey, you did it!
I did it! Fuck this game!
And you have to kill them all by running. All right,
let me get that thing just long enough to be like, oh god.
Neil is hands-on.
Okay.
At least you're out of that place.
How squishy and bad does this feel?
Quite.
Which button was... Okay, no, I got it.
This one's to reposition.
I hit more than one button to try to jump and it got weird.
Yeah, well.
It got weird.
Oh, that's not progress. Oh, we got it.
This is the sick content people come to us for.
Oh, yeah.
Alright. This does not feel great.
I honestly think that up here there's only shit for, there's the guy with the blueprint for Donkey Kong, but there's...
Is there like a run faster button somewhere in here?
This is the run fast button.
Playing Diddy Kong is the run fast button.
Yeah, so you gotta be
Tiny Kong to get in here. Because you need her.
Yeah, no, we're good.
We're done. Alright, Donkey Kong 64, quick, give it a review, but make your own rating system.
I'm going to give this 1 out of Scott. Because he played.
Tony!
I'm going to give this an orange grenade held for too long out of 10.
Ah, that's pretty good too. Mm. I was going to give it 3 peeled bananas out of 2 bananas.
Peeled seems better though.
I don't know. Cutting in on a good game now. Or at least a better game.
A gooder game.
God, do you remember HAL?
I remember HAL. I associate
Is that just with... like still recording or do you cut it up for...
I chop it in post.
Okay.
Yeah. We're gonna do a lot.
Well, I hope we don't lose everything.
No.
Oh man, the fact that we
just
lost...
played DK64, I think we bought everything.
Honestly, there was some good content in there.
There were some funny jokes. Oh wow, I've played this game, apparently.
You know, I associate the,
Oh, let's get a tutorial!
Let's see, time it. Let's see if it takes us as long as,
It's not. It won't take us. There's no possible.
There's no universe in which.
But I was saying, I associate the HAL Laboratories logo with Kirby Air Ride more than this.
Yeah.
Because we put a lot of time into that, too.
That's a good game.
There is nothing to do in that game, but it's a good game.
I have only played Kirby's Air Ride for 10 minutes, I think, once. And I did not understand how that worked.
It's a good,
Is it a racing game or not? I couldn't...
It's got a racing element, but the most fun thing is the city trial mode, which basically you get dropped into an arena. That's like a city with different biomes. There's a volcano, there's like platform
forest.
And you zoom around against your opponents, which typically is me, Tony, and Lucas.
Local co-op.
And then you would collect... ups, like buffs for your skills, so strength, speed, turning, flight,
weight,
whatever.
Yeah.
And then at the end of a predetermined amount of time, normally we would set it max, which is 7 minutes, because that gives you enough time to actually get your shit together.
You can also, you can also collect new stars other than the warp star for like how
you
want to play.
You start with the mini star, you don't even start with the core.
Interesting.
So you get different cards, you can pick a different ride.
Yeah. And then at the end, there's randomly generated sort of verses where it's like, it's a race, or it's a target shoot, or it's a beat.
There's that picture that shows up on Facebook every year.
When Lucas lost, or beat.
Lost.
Lucas got beat by a millisecond, a single millisecond.
Because
in a
it
race.
Shows your exact time.
Wow.
Yeah.
And,
God, it comes up every year.
Every year.
I guess he's probably going to show up and be on a guest on the show at
the
some
guy,
point.
The guy who beat Lucas.
Yeah.
So if this is a new game we're playing, should I, like, introduce myself again or something?
Oh, no, this is all going to be one video.
I'll
40-minute guest spot thing. Like when I had Veronica do Grand Theft Auto 5 with me.
Right.
So we're just doing an N64 block?
Yeah!
N64 block featuring part-time gamers.
Part-time gamers.
Well, half of
specifically
them.
Neil.
A part-time gamer.
Part of a part-time gamer.
If only I could be more of a full one.
Oh.
Good times.
Relatable
content. Right, this is...
We're off to a good start.
This is the first one where they did those weird combination
I love the combinations.
Stuff. Ah, shit, I wanted that.
Okay,
hold on.
Get the fire and get the boomerang guy.
I think it's fire and... Yeah, it's fire.
This is fire.
This one sucks.
Yeah. Throw it away.
How do you remember the combos?
I remember the combos. No, get that guy!
I ain't no fool.
That's the good one.
Oh shit, it's gone. We lost it. Hold on.
Okay,
I'm gonna respawn the enemies.
We're gonna try that again.
Well, that's convenient.
Yes, it is. Fire sword!
Yeah.
This is the best one.
What? I thought
Eat
it was gonna come down. Oh my god.
Yeah, no, this is your problem solver.
This is so goofy.
So the problem is that if you want to get every crystal shard, there are certain areas in each level where you need a specific combination.
You know what I found out the last time I played this game?
What's that?
I thought the coloring on the things that you had to overcome was always like a hint. About what you needed to do.
That does not look good.
It's literally
color. No, it looks terrible.
Sorry, you were saying.
It's literally color coded. Like,
oh, cool.
It tells you the two colors of the object tell you exactly what combo you need in order to break the object.
Oh, well, that's good.
I kind of wish that we figured that out as children.
As children, exactly.
Yeah.
As mere infants.
Because the last boss for this game is, like, weirdly the stuff of nightmares.
Yeah, it's pretty fucked up.
Hmm.
Like, it's kind of like fighting a baby Elderborn.
Is that a Souls thing?
No, that's a Cthulhu
thing. Ah, shit!
I mean, it is kind of a Souls thing because Bloodborne ripped heavily from... They cribbed heavily from Lovecraft.
Yeah.
You can
Does
get fire...
Fireball do anything crazy?
Yes, do it.
No, I need Double Bomb because that thing's all black.
Okay. Firebomb gives you, like... It gives you a jump that throws fireworks off around you.
That seems fun.
It is
I
fun.
Think this one is...
That, oh!
Yeah.
Oh, that's good,
oh,
too.
Rockets?
No, right. Rock and,
Come on, Kirby. Rock and bomb.
Rock and bomb is
go.
Dynamite.
See, because that thing was all black,
black,
you need
so
double black.
Double black.
Yeah, exactly.
That makes sense.
So, I...
So things that we could have figured out.
But we were idiot children, and then we grew up into idiot adults that are slightly more observant.
Idiot children who invested way too much time into DK64.
Shut the fuck up, we're not talking about that game anymore.
Seriously, not kidding.
We're off to a better
I
game.
I held the controller for like a minute, mm-hmm. and said no.
9 minutes to actual first level.
I'm actually like really scared about all these other games I used to love now. Mm-hmm. What if Banjo-Kazooie isn't as fun as it used to be?
I can guarantee you Banjo-Kazooie is still as fun.
What was it? Right, yeah, sorry. Super Bunny Hop did a really good video reviewing Shovel Knight. About how it's a really good game, but it's a game about nostalgia.
Yeah.
Because it is designed to be the way that we remember those old games, which is better than it actually is.
But, I mean, it is better than it
yeah,
actually
that's
is.
That's
so,
the point.
Yeah.
Like, it was made with like the Super Nintendo aesthetic in mind, but they cheated in little places. Like they had
they used colors that weren't available.
They added two colors that weren't available.
Yep.
The like pixel art is way more detailed.
The sheer frames of animation are
the sound card that they used was from a different system that had better capabilities.
Wasn't it like a Dreamcast sound card or
yeah.
something like that? Yeah.
Something like that.
Dreamcast was very good.
It did.
Man, the Dreamcast was a good system.
Never played it.
Not once?
Not once.
Oh my god, Choo Choo Rocket.
Mm-hmm.
Great game.
Until like, the last, I'm gonna say like 6 years or so, I just always remembered it as something from like, the days of yore.
Yeah. Well, I mean...
We didn't have a home console until the N64.
Yeah.
Weird. Yeah, I guess my first one was that I owned was a Sega Genesis.
Nice.
Technically, my first one was a Game Boy Color.
One of the video games that I'm the most interested in playing that I've never played before
yeah.
is a Sega Dreamcast game.
Which one?
It's called Illbleed.
Okay.
So it's this incredibly, like, wildly ambitious game. But essentially, the way it breaks down is you play as this girl who, like, survived a slasher movie-style... encounter at one point.
That sounds like your album.
And like is now giving lectures at schools and stuff like that about, you know, survivalism and making it through and persevering and whatever. And then her friends are like, hey, we're gonna go to this crappy horror movie marathon. You should come to the theater with us. And she's like,
that's a shitty thing to invite someone.
Did you guys be at the lecture I just gave? Or
that's like
But then her friends all go missing. So she goes to the theater to find them, and she gets each level is you going to a theater and getting transposed into the horror movie.
Weird.
And so the way the gameplay breaks down is you have a couple of different meters that you have to worry about, and one of them is health, one of them is energy, one of them is adrenaline. And
right.
you got to keep yourself from getting scared or attacked.
This sounds so, so ahead of its time.
Wildly, and that's kind of why it failed.
Yeah.
Because But
I mean, that's kind of why the Dreamcast failed.
Yeah.
1999,
like,
getting the GameCube
but
style
the,
stuff already.
The actual gameplay...
There's a thing beneath
you. I know.
Okay.
It's coming up. The actual gameplay of the game is you entering rooms, and you have to use your sixth sense, which is just one of the other meters that you have to keep calm,
yeah.
to basically mark anything that you think might be a trap. And the traps, if you don't mark them, go off and either hurt you or scare you, and that gets rid of your health and your adrenaline. Mm-hmm. And so you have to mark them to debunk them so that you can move through without taking too much damage.
Because you know how this kind of thing works. This sounds like, because especially with like the Friday the 13th game recently came out, mm-hmm. and there were a whole bunch of like serial killer style games.
Dead by Dawnlight or whatever.
Yeah.
Dawn by
Dead
Night.
Dead by Daylight.
Yeah, whatever.
That sounds like the kind of thing that would like go like crazy today.
Yeah, and it's impossible to find now because they undershipped it because it didn't sell. So like you can get a copy for $800 or you can port it.
Yeah.
And okay, so it's actually funny because one of my favorite games of all time is actually a port of a Dreamcast game to GameCube.
Which one?
Skies of Arcadia Legends.
Oh yeah.
Because it's
that game is so easy to break though.
Yes, it is.
Dead Rising.
I know that now, but as a child I didn't get it. And that was my first big JRPG.
Okay.
I mean, it was your first one, and it was also one of the ones that you spent the most time with.
Like, I distinctly remember there were a couple of years in a row when I would start a new game on, like, New Year's Eve, and I would get to the same boss at, like, purely by chance, not by intent. I would get to the same boss just before the countdown every year.
Where
it became a weird tradition for me.
Yeah, I remember that, too.
Yeah, I played that game as someone who, frankly, I am bad at playing JRPGs.
So this is the part where Painter just paints a dick.
Yeah, I always wondered.
Painter, how dare you?
She just gets really mad.
He destroyed the dick!
And now I'm gonna make a real boss monster.
Yeah.
But
also,
yeah,
hang on. Speaking of, we were talking about stands. This is a fucking stand. This is a stand battle.
Oh yeah, if I ever saw one. A lady who can paint things into reality?
She's just Rohan.
That's fair.
I mean, she's not turning you into a book.
Not yet.
Fair.
Give her time.
Fair.
And like, this Kirby could have a stand power too.
Everyone else's?
Yes. His stand power is to copy abilities around him. Oh yeah, and then she just...
It's kind of like fighting Tinker Knight. But you were saying, you know.
What
yeah,
was I saying? We were talking about Dreamcast...
Skies of Arcadia.
So, I played through that game also on GameCube way after its time, and I just remember realizing that you could break the game really easily towards the end of the game because, like, someone gets a power that just blocks all physical attacks, someone else gets a power that blocks all magic attacks, and then another person just, like, charges up your super meter, and you can just do that forever.
Okay,
that's
so
awesome.
There, you have your main DPS, who's the guy who has the Cutlass Vice.
Right, he's the guy.
Yeah.
He's the guy.
Aka and Fina are your two other, like, pretty much constant party members, and they basically handle buffs.
Aka's the one with the big boomerang, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I liked her.
Yes.
She was good.
She was cool. And she's the one who can... She gets an ability that uses Sun Meter that can make you immune to spells, which
mm-hmm.
is great, because by that point in the game... A lot of enemies have an instant kill spell.
God damn it.
And then Vrachva, the pirate guy, he's a fisherman technically. He's like a Captain Ahab character who's chasing this sky whale that destroyed his ship and killed his son.
Hmm.
He gets an ability, some kind of focus ability, where he basically goes into defense mode where he takes greatly reduced damage and like charges your meter, like your party's meter up a lot.
Oh yeah.
So he's always alive, you always have enough meter that you can do your other buff abilities, and you can basically do one of Vice's supers every turn.
That's
pretty much.
Handy.
And it's really silly.
And
I ended up doing it a different way, because I remember like reading later after I beat the game how much you could break it in a different way.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I ended up doing it, I think Vice has one that prevents all physical.
Pirate Shield, Skull Shield,
something like that. So I would
right, you can shuriken now, don't you?
I would use Vice's to block all physical damage. I would use Ika's to block all magic damage, which meant the only thing that could hurt me were the, like, I have a special ability,
kind
of the way that I have, you also have one.
So a boss.
But none of those would actually kill in one shot.
So you could always heal back up.
So I just had my, like, super heal lady, and so I had two people on my team that would just focus every turn to give my meter up.
Yeah.
If they ever did a special move that went through my blocking stuff, I just full healed it with one spell. And every time I got to 4 meter, it was just like, cool, let me do the, like, world-ending, blows-everything-up move. Yeah. And that's how I beat that game.
Yeah, if you had full meter, you had two options for, like, a super move that your entire crew could do.
Okay. I thought I was seeing things for a moment there. No. I was like, are the things you're throwing just, like, phasing out of existence
see,
and appearing?
His,
like,
his ninja ability.
You guys were talking about breaking the game, so I got the best weapon in the game.
This
to try.
It's exploding shurikens.
Exploding shurikens that are impossible to, like, you can't stop them mid-throw,
yeah.
Like you can with some projectiles, because they disappear.
it's hitstand.
Wow.
I think I need, double green. I wonder if I can get back up.
Yep.
Hey!
What were you just talking about?
It's kind of Arcadia.
That's Arcadia, right? So that sounds like exactly how I imagined that you would beat the game, which is very cautiously.
I went through a lot of that game not doing that because it felt dumb. I ended up liking that game a lot more when you were doing the, like, pirate ship fights and stuff.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't break the game in the same way. It was a lot more interesting to
me. I also, like, broadly speaking, I love the side quests. Like, I enjoyed the main game. The side quests are what you're doing that for. You are doing that so that you can feel like a pirate.
Let's not be like, do you just have to fight this person again?
Oh, she's your friend.
Now Painter hangs out and gives me cool stuff. I know this.
Okay. That was a very fast turnaround for her to be your friend.
Yeah, I know, right?
It's almost like JoJo Part 4.
Yeesh.
So sad that I don't have any more JoJo's to watch.
There are two... Sorry, if you have full meter in Skies of Arcadia, there are two super moves that you can do that have the option of doing. One where your party literally flies up into space.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you have a...
I forgot what this mixture was, and then he did it, and I was like, alright.
What is it?
Your party flies up into space.
That looks... like a not fun time.
And they drop the moons down on whoever you're fighting.
That's
the big one. And then the other one you can do is because at one point you get your own pirate ship, and part of the thing that you can do is fly all around the world and find NPCs and recruit them to be part of your crew.
Nice.
And they all have like their own side quests and requirements and things before they'll join. But to like 100% the game, you need to get all of them.
That makes sense.
And they'll all serve some function back at your island home base once you get them. They'll be a merchant, or they'll let you make cosmetic changes, or they'll give you some buffs in combat.
Look, it's the worst King DDD.
He does not look good.
Not very great.
Not great. Mm-hmm. Anyway, sorry. The other super move is you call all of them out, and they all do something that either buffs you or damages the enemy.
That's pretty handy.
And you get like a custom animation depending on who you have in like... on your ship at the time.
They'd have to account for that, yeah.
Because there's two of every role. There's two different jesters, there's two different engineers, etc., etc. Oh.
Really?
Oh my
Just
god.
Just stand there.
But the moon drop attack that you talked about.
Yeah.
I'm so good at what I do.
Wow.
In Costume Quest 2, which is a game that's going to be showing up on this channel soon, the special, you don't have to necessarily unlock this, but you can unlock this costume that you can get, is like a solar system costume, where you have like a sun head and there's like little satellite-y planets stuck on with like pipe cleaners and whatever.
Okay.
And when you go into the actual fight mode, you become the solar system. And your super attack is like 80s sci-fi style, like bringing a Galaga fleet to blow up your enemy while becoming a black hole. It's just fucking awesome. It's the coolest.
Nice.
Reminds me of that moon drop thing that you were talking about.
Totally.
Which also, like, that's... All of these boss moves are, like, just Sephiroth's meteor, but it doesn't take 20 minutes.
Yeah, I keep thinking of
just
Gaia.
I want to time this.
Oh, yeah.
I want to time, like, one of the special finishing moves from Final Fantasy against the intro of Donkey Kong 64 and see which one takes longer.
Oh boy. I've never actually beaten a Final Fantasy game.
I beat 10 and I beat Tactics.
Oh yeah. I remember Tactics was on Game Boy, right?
Yeah, Tactics Advance.
Yeah, that was
there is a difference. That one I loved that one. It's like I top down isometric game.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. I beat 15 because I pre-ordered 15.
Right. I still gotta try that.
The farthest I've ever gotten in one is 6.
Okay.
And that is because at some point, you do a lot of stuff that feels like it's leading up to the end of the game. And then it's like, yo, number one, this isn't the end of the game. Number two, all those characters that you spent the entire game collecting, you have to go collect again. And I was just kind of like, no, I'm good.
That's rough.
I might be able to play through it today, but like I was young and I didn't play a lot of JRPGs back then.
15 is, I think, did a lot of things right because it took actual combat instead of RPG-style combat, which
made
the game a little bit more immersive for me. And the characters are very likable, and the DLC campaigns are a lot of fun as well. Like, there's a whole Metal Gear Solid 3-style third-person shooter stealth campaign where you play as Prompto, which fucking incredible.
Also, Prompto is basically you.
Yeah, I love that guy. then Crystal Chronicles, spent a lot of fucking time with that game.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that one.
Yeah.
I didn't spend a long time with that game, but I did have an SP, and my buddy had that game, and we all plugged in, got to do the whole four-player thing with that a couple times.
Yeah, it was very cool use of that technology.
Yeah.
And I was pissed when they didn't bring it back, like, this console that I'm holding in my hands right now would have been literally perfect for a Crystal Chronicles port.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yep.
That's literally all the tech that you need.
Exactly. But maybe now they'll do it with the Switch, because Switch multiplayer makes it so that you can bring multiple handhelds. So fingers crossed there. And then also I've spent a lot of time with 10, but that was more recently. And I have a copy, an original PlayStation 1 copy of Final Fantasy VII, that I think we should do a video of pretty soon.
I'm going to say don't invite me to that one.
Not a fan?
I have tried to play that game more than once.
I've never played it before, that's why I'm interested.
The last time I did it, I went through the intro dungeon, I started doing some of the other stuff, and... like, it's pretty early on, there's something involving a church, that's the last thing I remember, and then just kind of being like, I don't want to play this anymore.
Yeah, that's the worst feeling. Especially when it's a game that, like, people like.
Oh,
it's like, people are like, man, you'll love Undertale, and it's like, probably I would, I just don't want to play it.
I do love Undertale.
I also love Undertale.
Exactly, see? It's like, I totally get it, I just don't want to play it.
So I also really love that kind of... shoot-em-up game, shmups, as they call them, with the, like, top-down dodge bullets thing.
Right, yeah.
Which is what they turn the combat, the RPG combat, into for Undertale. So
yeah, it's got the...
That is just my kind of game.
Nice.
And so I'm pretty into it.
That makes sense.
And it appeals to me because of the writing and the character that goes
The characters are very good.
They are just dedicated to the aesthetic as well.
Yeah.
Like, the music and the world is just so on point for such limited resources.
It's good.
Yeah. Yeah, the music is, like, I've never even played the game, but the music is absolutely astounding.
Well, I mean, that's what Toby Fox does.
I'm going to do a plug right now. Chime, he's a DJ on YouTube. He did a absolutely stunning remix of the Undertale theme song.
I'm down.
I'll cut it in at some point in the video, but it's just the craziest. Definitely check it out.
Yeah, I'll have to check that out. Like mashups.
Yeah.
But like mashups of music I don't like.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not a huge fan of what was the name of those guys who did Take Me Out from like forever ago?
Yeah.
I think that song's kind of boring.
Sure.
Also really don't like Milkshake. But those two songs together are freaking amazing.
That's awesome.
I have a friend who really does not like rap on principle. And I won him over by showing him the remix of Swimming Pools by Kendrick Lamar with Radioactive
by Imagine Dragons. Yeah.
Which that got him to be like, okay, there's something to this. And
Swimming Pools is a good song.
Brown and Yellow is going to be Earth and Electric. Sorry, I just kind of...
No. I completely don't know. He's got it. But those things scared the shit out of me.
They're not cool. Get out of here, you! Get out of here!
They're so smiley when you're looking at them.
They're kind of like booze.
They are literally booze.
Get in my face!
You can't.
I know.
That's what's scary.
I need electrical power. Where do I get that? Where do I get electric and dirt? Oh, here's
electric.
Well, there went electric! Alright. Look, they're just like piranha plants, but worse in every way.
They lifted, they cribbed a lot of stuff from Mario.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do? It's Nintendo.
Yeah.
If anybody's allowed to rip off Nintendo, it's still Nintendo.
You're not wrong. And I'm not,
Oh, is that guy Rock?
I think so.
Oh, I think they're Boomerang.
Nah. Hold on.
He must be
wrong. Oh, God, shoot!
Well, give it a
shot. Try eating him, yeah.
Just go for it.
I just want that out of my way. You prick. Oh. Golly.
You're gonna die.
I am.
This is going well.
Get over here, both of you!
Oh, he's gone.
He's fucking... Oh, no, he's there. Go see him.
Oh, wow, he's going.
Yeah, he's giving her.
You still catch him. Oh, God.
You prick! Oh, man. That feels bad. All right, I need one...
I wouldn't have wanted it any other way.
Need one rock-type power.
It's gotta be that guy. He's the only other one.
He's the only other enemy.
You gotta go backwards.
No, you can't.
I can't.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Is there anything after this before the end of the level?
Nope. Once I clear the screen, level ends. At least those stupid cat
it's
things.
Gotta be this
could, maybe this is something where you just have to replay it.
No.
You can't get everything in one run.
You absolutely can if you do it smart.
Okay.
Get over here, you. I do it also.
Wait, what?
The electrical thing. Ugh.
He was very close to death.
Yeah. I'm really tempting fate this time. Wasn't he hanging out here?
Yeah,
he was. For fuck's sake. Alright.
Well, maximum tomato.
Bingo!
Very nicely done, very nice.
Alright.
Yeah,
sure. There we go.
What are my controls on this game?
So you gotta use the D-pad.
Alright.
Jump and suck.
Jump and suck, I got
jump
it.
Jump and suck. And then this is how, like, up on that is how you get your stuff.
Great.
You picked a great time to hand off the controller.
I thought so.
When you're on the verge of death.
I did all the work to get us to the verge of death.
Did this guy give me a power?
Spike,
yeah.
Alright, we'll try it.
Double electric.
Yeah, that one's cool. I can, like, charge it up or something, right?
No,
yeah.
But it's really good.
You feel really slow.
You are slow.
If you hit B while you've been hit.
Oh, dang it.
So, when you have it above your head, you have to hit the B button to chuck it forward instead of throwing it up. And then also, if while you're full of air, you hit B, you'll spat it out and then drop quicker.
Yeah, give me that.
Boom.
What? That is not what I was thinking.
No, it's a much bigger electrical field that he gives you immunity. Also, he turns you into...
turns me into a fucking raver.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can rave.
You guys want to go vape?
Ooh. Hey, it's me over at Hachimachi YouTube channel. I got some new fidget spinner tricks for you. Let me bust them out.
Ain't nothing gonna kill me now.
Except those.
Nope, we're good.
We're fine. That almost went
poorly. That almost touched me.
Oh, that's health.
What?
The popsicle.
Yeah. Only one.
It's okay, you don't look sad anymore. Why?
I want to see what this pig gives me.
Nothing!
Yeah.
Damn.
But there's, I think, some other cool powers in this area, so...
I feel so, like, slow.
If you double tap the move button, you'll sprint.
That's sprinting. What does fire electric do? I remember not being impressed.
That's not...
Nope.
Oh, okay. It's okay, I'm not...
Well...
I can't remember fire electric, actually.
That's not the right button.
Oh.
Oh, come on now. There we go.
A good color palette.
Oh yeah!
What?
That sucks.
Oh, but I'm so much faster, I love it. Yes! Run, Kirby!
This is this is what Neil wants.
Speed run, here we go. I got the right powers, we're going.
Set yourself on fire and run.
How fast can I get through the rest of this level?
I remember using this and hating it.
Woo! Oh.
Shit.
Right.
We're off to
a if I hit people when I'm on fire, it just kills them, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
But that guy there...
Eat it! Oh, I can't super jump, or I can't float jump when I'm doing it. Oh, hi. Hi.
Another Boo-type floating bad guy.
Yeah. Let's just go over here. Oh, hey, you're back.
He will give you spike powers, by the way, which are probably better than...
Heck no. Oh god, the face. Get the hell.
It's a shame you didn't have a weapon that you could use to...
Oh no. Oh. Okay, we can do this.
Alright, here we go.
Eat it!
Woo! There was a one-up up there, by the way.
Also, there's a shard back in
it's
the...
It's fine.
Back in the palace.
Is he gonna right, get it?
Right. Oh yeah, it's easy. So, you gotta go up here.
Back up.
Yeah. And then, hard
got
left.
This.
Yeah.
This is the worst power.
It is the best, Tony. Don't eat him.
Boom.
Nothing can oh god. Those are going through the wall.
They put the no clip mod on.
they're using Anubis as a stand.
Shut up.
Have fun.
Yeah. Oop.
There's a shard down there, too.
That's fine. Alright, quick rating of the game out of 10.
Oh, boy, out of 10? Okay.
No, sorry, out of your own rating system. Own rating system. Tony?
Mario 64 out of 10.
Oh, high praise.
That's very high. I love this game.
I'd probably give this, like, a static electricity out of... out of frizzy hair.
That's a problem for you.
Well, sometimes. A little bit.
I'm gonna give this game a Nightmare in Dreamland out of Air Ride.
Ooh.
I don't know what that means.